You mentioned a problem at Bridlington Station. I should like to visit this station. Could you mark it on the local map?
Of course. It's a suburban railway station. You might take a cab there.
This is an absolute scandal. It's always the same with these rail companies. No respect for the customer.
Please calm down, sir. What is your concern?
Concern? What is my concern? I'll tell you what my concern is. Last night, I were on the train, as usual, with my colleague, heading home. Then along came this ridiculous ticket inspector, who started arguing that our tickets were invalid. He made us get off the train, and he was extremely rude about it.
Were you aboard the train that vanished last night?
Yes. I heard that it disappeared. But I don't care because we would have stopped before then anyway. Our tickets were valid and no doubt about it. And then, to top it all, the ticket inspector pushed everyone else out too, except for a bunch of rich. Well, of course their type don't need a ticket.
Can you recall anything more specific about this fortunate group?
Well, yes. They were all foreigners. Spanish-looking toffs with snake eyes.
Goodbye, sir. Good day to you, sir.
Good day. To whom am I speaking?
My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is...
Are you a representative of this damned railway company? Because I have a complaint.
We are not from the railway company. We are...
Well, in that case, Mr. Shamrock Flomes, please excuse me. But I'm not in the mood for idle chit-chat at the moment.
You must be Mr. Robinson, is that correct?
Yes.
I am leading the investigation of the disappearing train. It would help if you could answer my questions.
Ah, well, all right. I have nothing to hide.
I presume it was you who placed the order for the special wagon.
Yes. It was to transport my valuable prototype safely to London. My prototype is a revolutionary device. It is capable of producing electricity. I'm a businessman and an engineer. I had already found several potential customers for my invention, but I was very optimistic about the directors' board who were travelling on the train last night.
You mentioned a directors' board. Which company do they own?
The Chilean Barcazas Company. I had made an appointment with them. Now they are lost, along with the train and my prototype.
What do you know about the Barcazas Company?
It's a large South American company. They showed a great deal of interest in my prototype, and they seemed wealthy enough to do business with.
This revolutionary machine of yours, was it very valuable?
For God's sake, sir, it is priceless. It could change the world we live in, and yet... I was selling it for almost nothing. I am a humanitarian, you see. I do not know if I will ever be able to get over this disaster, I cannot believe that it disappeared with that damn train.
Mr. Robinson, could you please clarify? Were you travelling alongside your prototype?
Yes, I was. But I had to step off the train. And all because of this stupid station master.
I received a telegram declaring that an important person, a Mr. Bronsby, wished to see you in the waiting room. I merely informed you of this.
Mr. Bronsby is a wealthy gentleman. His interest in my invention was truly unexpected. So yes, of course, I agreed to see him. Unfortunately, he wasn't there. I thought perhaps he might have been delayed, so I chose to wait a while. But despite my requests, the train left the station without me. Absolutely unacceptable.
The timetable is strict. We cannot wait any longer. The regulations require the train to be on time.
You are an idiot. You will pay for it. I will sue you.
The ticket inspector forced all the passengers from the train, except for the directors of the Barcazas Chilean Company. Insurance policy for Robinson's machine. A significant sum.
Good day to you, gentlemen. How may I help you?
Good day to you, sir. My name is Sherlock Holmes. I am investigating the unfortunate disappearance of last night's train.
I see. I'm Station Master Bertram, but my supervisor has not informed me about this. I do not know if...
Do not worry. I have only a few questions. Station Master Everett from Evesham told us that you reported a problem with some passengers last night.
Indeed. This train is a regular line for those who work at Nottingham. But yesterday, everyone was asked to get off the train here at my station. I've no idea why, and it delayed the train. But the worst of it is that now I have to deal with two furious passengers who are complaining about the company's service. They stayed here the whole night, but people do not usually pay much attention to the regulations, you see. There are very strict and clear rules. Paragraph 234 of Article 2G-43 states that in the event of a complaint, you must...
Yes, yes, thank you. I understand. Apart from the passengers disembarking, did you notice anything else that was unusual last night?
I did, and I mentioned it in my report to our higher management on the matter.
What was it?
Sorry, but I can't tell you. The station master's reports are confidential.
Confidential, you say? How long have you been working here?
I have worked here long enough to be quite capable of managing a railway station.
Let me speak frankly, Mr. Bertram. Your age and your lack of confidence in your position are quite apparent. You cannot deny that you have only recently completed your studies.
I was at the top of my class.
Listen here, young man. I am aware that you wish to protect yourself behind all these regulations, but I represent the law.
And you are obstructing the investigation of an important case I would suggest that you cooperate with Mr. Holmes. Think of your career.
Ah, that is... Well, I'll tell you everything. First of all, I scolded the ticket inspector, for it was he who asked the passengers to leave the train. It was not his right to do so. He was very rude. And then, later on, I received a most peculiar telegram from my colleague at Chesterfield Station, the next stop along the line.
What did the telegram say?
Well, that was the peculiar thing. It was almost unreadable. It was full of errors and awfully vague. It was hard to understand if the train had correctly passed that station or not. You can read it for yourself.
We ought to visit Chesterfield Station. We need to confirm if the station master saw the train or not.